John Thomas says his former friend Denise Lewis falsely accused him of sexual harassment. Denise says John is angry because their friendship never turned into romance.
Now, when did you make this report of sexual harassment?
After the week after I moved into my apartment.
Why?
Because he tried to force himself on me after I moved the after we moved the refrigerator and the bedroom furniture into my apartment.
Well, tell me about that, madam.
Okay, after the things were moved into the apartment, he laid down on my, we put everything in the living room because I had to paint the bedroom. He laid down on the mattress and he called me in there and he threw me down on the mattress and started making sexual moves on me. And it took me about a couple minutes to push him off of me and I asked him to leave.
And he left?
After some screaming and yelling, and yes, he did.
What kind of screaming and yelling?
I was screaming to get out of my apartment, that you don't live here.
And he left?
After some time, and he left when he got ready to leave.
So that's when you filed a complaint of sexual harassment against him?
Not only for that reason, was because the Saturday morning when he was supposed to come back and get the truck, I asked him to leave. We had an argument. I asked him to leave.
So you still have the truck?
This truck is still there. He has the keys to the truck.
Okay. So he said, so he had his car, and he wanted you to help him take the truck back.
Right.
What happened then?
I didn't open the door for him.
Why?
Because I was upset with him because of what he had tried to do. Okay, he never came to me and asked me to try and work things out, to try and say, okay, I owe you this money. Let's try and make some type of arrangements. The next thing I knew, he had left a letter on the counter of where I worked, and it was a bill for how much he assumed that I owe him.
So tell me when you made this allegation of sexual harassment. After you got the bill?
No, I made it like a few days later because he was calling and harassing me at work.
He was calling and asking you for what?
He was calling. He said he wanted to get together and talk. And I said, I don't want anything else to do with you because of your behavior, because you have been harassing me.
When did you make that statement to him?
I made it on Monday. And I asked him not to call me again and that I will pay him his money.
So did you pay him the money?
No, I did not.
Why?
Because he kept harassing me.
Just a minute. Why didn't you pay him the money? Maybe if you paid him the money, he would stop harassing you. Maybe if you paid him the bill, he would feel as if he wasn't so used.
Yeah.
And then he would leave you alone.
Yeah, well, maybe if he had come to me as an adult and not someone threatening me with gang violence and I'm going to get the Bloods to kill you and this and that, maybe if he would have come to me in an appropriate manner, I would have been more than happy to settle with him, just like I tried to call him 2 weeks ago. And I asked him, why did you file this lawsuit against me? And I said, can we come to some kind of agreement? Because I want this to go away. And his comment was, after several moments of silence, at 27 years old, was, you started it.
Well, Miss Lewis, you started it. Let me tell you something. I'm a woman. And I take allegations of sexual harassment in the workplace very seriously. But I resent it when women use allegations of sexual harassment as one-upmanship. And I'm telling you right now, the story that's coming through my head is an older lady with a lot more experience, has a guy 5-6 years younger than she is, who's clearly smitten with her. And what's coming out of her mouth is, no, no, yes, yes. No, no, yes, yes. You let him move you into another apartment? You're a smart lady. All you had to do was say, I'm happy where I am, John. I don't mind having coffee with you when we're here. You seem like a nice young man, but you know, this is not a romantic thing. So you let him help you out once. And instead of doing the nice thing, the right thing, by totally cutting him off so that you're fair to him, you're not playing mind games with his head, you call him again when you need help. So he's saying to himself, she really likes me. I don't care what she says. She's letting me rent a truck with her and move her stuff into her apartment and help her place the furniture where it is. So clearly, she may be saying no, no, but her eyes are saying yes, yes.
Judge.